Hello students, today we are going to study the chapter 5 Markov sources. The first point is Markov's statistical model for the information source. Markov source is represented in the graphical form, where the states are represented by the nodes of the graph and the transition between the state is represented by the directed line from the initial to the final state. So the state transition and the symbol generation can also be illustrated by using the figure. We can call it as a tree diagram. Suppose there is a three sources A, B, C generates the different possible messages. Suppose the 1, 2 and 3 are the nodes number and generates the three messages A, B and C with the different probabilities. Suppose A generates the message itself with the probability, one node it generates the message A with the probability 1 by 2. It generates the second message B with having the probability 1 by 4 from 1 to 2 state. Likewise, 2 generates the message A of probability 1 by 4 to the 1, that is transition between 1 to 2. So this is the one kind of the diagram. So A 1 to 2 B message, 2 to 1 A message, likewise you can generate the different messages. So how can this diagram can be represented into the simple form for the state, different states, that is for state 1, state 2 or state 3, or symbol 1, symbol 2 and symbol 3, right? So suppose there is a one source generates the three messages 1 to 1, 1 to 2 and 1 to 3. Again the one source, because the one generates the message itself, right? So 1 to 1 is also node present, right? So 1 to 1 having the probability is 1 by 2 and the symbol A is selected having the probability 1 by 3, because 3 are the symbols. So why out of 3, the symbol A having the probability 1 by 3, again symbol B having the probability 1 by 3 and symbol C or at the node 3 again having the probability 3. So A 1 to 1 is 1 by 2, A 1 to 1 again generates the 3 messages, so 1 by 2, 1 to 2 is 1 to 2 is B message, so 1 by 4 and 1 to 3 message 3 node 3, so C is equal to 1 by 3. So 1 to 3 node is C, symbol is 1 by 4. Again this A message generates the 2 node, generates the B message up to the 2 nodes, so having the probability B F of 1 by 4, so it is 1 by 4. From the B again 3 messages can be generated to the 1, 2 and 3 possible messages, so 2 to 1. So 2 to 1 having the symbol A having the probability 1 by 4, 2 to 2 having the symbol B having the probability 1 by 2 and 2 to 3 having the C symbol having the probability 1 by 4. Likewise you can generate for the 3. So for example the symbol is emitted like A to A, its probability is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, it is 1 by 4, 1 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 3, so it becomes 1 by 12, so the probability is 1 by 12. Again A to B, if the symbol is AB, A to B, so the probability will becomes 1 by 4 into 1 by 2, it is 1 by 8, 1 by 8 multiplied by 1 by 3, so it becomes 1 by 24. Again A to C, so probability will becomes 1 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2, 1 by 8, 1 by 8 multiplied by 1 by 3, so again 1 by 24. So likewise you can generate the all messages. So symbols emitted and the probability. So this is for the node 1. So you can extract for the node 2 or state 2 and for the state 3 also. So repeating the all process. That is Markov sources is represented in the graphical form, where the states are represented by the nodes of the graph, the state is represented by the nodes of the graph and the transition between the states is represented by the directed line from the initial to the final state. The state transition and the symbol generation can also be illustrated by using the tree diagram. So in this way you can draw the tree diagram. So there are some formulas for the Markov sources. So entropy, first formula, it is defined as the weighted average of the entropy of the symbols emitted from each state. That is entropy of each state. Suppose there are three states, so you can define the three entropies. So state are the 1, 2, 3, so you have to define the three entropies: entropy for one state, entropy for the second state, and entropy for the third state. So HI is equal to, I is represented the state, summation of J is equal to 1 to N P of IJ log of P of IJ. IJ is the, P of IJ is the conditional probability, and its unit is bits per symbol. PIJ is the conditional probability, it indicates the change in the state of source from I to G. The entropy, this is the state entropy. If you have to define the source entropy, that is, if there is a one single source, one generates the three messages or three states, so you can define the state entropy. Now the source entropy, source entropy is summation I is equal to 1 to N PI HI. Its definition is entropy of the source is the average entropy of each state. So if you take the average of each state entropy, then you will get the source entropy. So it is given as a summation I is equal to 1 to N PI HI, where H is equal to, so that is HI will be converted by this formula. So I represent this formula only. So H is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N PI, summation J is equal to 1 to N P of IJ log of P of IJ. So of course you can use the base 2. So PI is the probability of source is in the I state. And now the average information content per symbol is nothing but G is equal to, G of N is equal to 1 by N summation I P of MI log of P of MI, where P of MI is the sequence of MI of this N symbols from the source. So N is the length of that source. So let us take one problem. See the information source graph and find the following terms. That is source entropy and average information content per symbol G1, G2, G3. 1, 2, 3 is the length of that symbol. So there is a two nodes, 1 and 2, represents one probability, one probability is 1 by 2 and second probability is also 1 by 2. And 1 generates the A symbol of having the probability 3 by 4 and 2 generates the second symbol B is having the probability 3 by 4. And from the 1 to 2 there is a transition C symbol 1 by 4 and from the 2 to 1 as again transition is 1 by 4. Now the source entropy H is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N PI HI, and I state entropy, I for first state, that is first state H1 will become summation J is equal to 1 to N PIJ log of P of IJ. So from the first source it generates the two messages, 1 to 2 and 1 to 1. So 1 to 2 the probability will be 1 2 and 1 to 1 the probability will be 1 1. So 1 to 2 generates the C symbol having the probability 1 by 4 and 1 to 1 generates the A symbol having the probability 3 by 4. So ith state entropy will become P of 1 1, this is log of 1 divided by P of 1 1 plus P of 1 2 log of 1 divided by P of 1 2, that is 3 by 4 log of 4 by 3 plus 1 by 4 log of 4. It is equal to 0.8112 bits per symbol. I am skipping here calculation part, that you can do on your calculator easily. Now for H2, that is the second state. So from 2 to 1 and 2 to 2, so 2 to 1 the symbol generates C having the probability 1 by 4 and 2 to 2 symbol generates B having the probability 3 by 4. So it is 2 1 and 2 2. So H2 will become probability of P21 log of 1 divided by P21 plus probability of P22 log of 1 divided by P22. So 1 by 4 log of 4 plus 1 3 by 4 log of 4 by 3. So it becomes again 0.8122 bits per symbol. Now the entropy of the source will become H is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n pi hi. Hi is 2 state. So pi for the both state are the 1 by 2 1 by 2, which is given into the problem itself. So 1 by 2 probability and second probability is also 1 by 2. So p is already given. So 1 by 2 h first state entropy was 0.8112 and second state is again same 0.8112. So it becomes entropy of the source will become 0.8112 bits per symbol. So there are two sources. Now the second part is average information content per the symbol G1, G2, G3. So here the G1 is the message of length 1, G2 is the message of length 2 and G3 is the message of length 3. Gn is nothing but 1 by n summation of I P of mi log of P of mi, right? So you have to define these all diagram converted into the tree diagram for the state 1, for the state 2 and for the state 3, right? So 1 generates the 2 symbol 1 2, again this 1 generates the 2 symbol 1 2, again this 1 generates the 2 symbol 1 2, again this 1 generates the 2 symbol 1 2, again this 2 generates the 2 symbol 1 2, again 1 2 and again 1 2. So likewise you can define. So 1 to 1 the symbol A generates having the probability 3 by 4. So you, likewise you can evaluate the all part. So I am skipping the drawing part. So the source emitted is A having the probability 3 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2. So it becomes 27 by 128. Likewise the second is AAC. So AAC is the probability is 1 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2. Likewise 9 by 128. So likewise you will get the all entropies. Sorry, all probabilities of the source emitted. Now draw for the second one. Second state generates again 2 symbols 1 2. Again this generates 2 symbols 1 2. Again generates 1 symbols 1 2. So the source emitted will be the CAA having the probability 9 by 128. How 9 by 128? That is 3 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2. Now CAC, that is CAC, so 3 by 128. So likewise you can withdraw the all source emitted and its respective probability. Now calculate the message length. Message length M1 for first message 1 1 ABC, length M2 AAA second stage, and length M3 already evaluated. Length A, that is A B and C. How A, the A symbols generates 3 by 4 into multiplied by 1 by 2. So 3 by 8. So it is a 3 by 8. Again B symbol symbols 3 by 8 multiplied by 1 by 2. Again 3 by 8 and the C symbol, check for the C symbol. It is 1 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2. Sorry, 1 by 4 multiplied 1 by 4 itself. So 1 by 4. So again AA for the first source to the second source. So for the stage M2, which is AA, that is 3 by 4 multiplied by 3 by 4 multiplied by 1 by 2. So you will get the 9 by 32. AC, CC, CB, CA, BC and BB for two stages, both stages. So AC, CC, CB and BC. So likewise you can evaluate the all entropies and problems. So stage 3 we already evaluated triple A to the CBB, and so triple A, and here the CAA 2 to the BBB. So now for the G1, if n is equal to 1, your formula will become 1 by 1 summation I is equal to 1 to m p of m1 log of p of m1. So for the first stage or G1, 3 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 3 by 8, that is 3 by 8 log of 8 by 3 plus 3 by 8 log of 8 by 3 plus 1 by 4 log of 4. So you will get G1 1.5612. I skipping here calculation part. You can this is assignment for you to calculate the all parts. Now the G2 that is 1 by 2 log of this formula. So you will get the G2 1.28 bits per symbol, and G3, so summation of all these three in the formula, so you will get 1.139 bits per symbol. So in this way you can evaluate the G1 and G2 and G3. Thank you.